Hello. My name is Mohammed Hassan. I am an Arab American. I grew up right here in America. But since 9/11, you people tend to generalize or stereotype people like me. But I implore you, please, don't confuse me with acts of terrorism here in America and around the world. I am asking you people to please just give me the opportunity to represent you in the WWE. Thank you. Praise Allah. Now please be respectful as my manager, Khosrow Debari, translates for our Arab brothers.
Salam. اسم من خسرو دیوریست، اینم شد دوستم محمد حسن. ما دوتا از بچگی تو آمریکا زندگی کردیم. برای سپتامبر 11 شماها ما رو نگاه میکنیم مثل حیوان هستیم. فکر میکنیم ما دوتا مثل بجنسا هستیم. ما آدم خوبه، من بهت نشون میدم وقتی ما میایم مثل شما کار کنیم توی WWE. مرسی.
Well, that's Mohammed Hussein, an Arab American, and I think that our Raw audience and our fans worldwide are going to be able to give him a fair shake, an equal opportunity.
Well, ladies,
this is where I grew up, right next door to all of you. I went to the same schools, I ate the same food, I even watched the same television shows, and there was never any animosity between us. Not until 9/11. 9/11 changed everything for me and my people. You look at us differently now, and don't say you don't. Be honest. All I want is a chance. Don't judge me because I'm of Arab descent. Judge me because of my talent, my skill. Judge me for me. I just want the opportunity to represent you in the WWE. Thank you.
Salam. اسم من خسرو دیوری است. اینم دوستم محمد حسن. ما از بچگی اینجا زندگی کردیم. با همدیگه رفتیم مدرسه، با همدیگه غذا خوردیم، هم با همدیگه تلویزیون نگاه میکردیم. ولی برای سپتامبر 11 شماها ما رو نگاه میکنیم مثل حیوان هستیم. ما رو نگاه میکنیم مثل بدجنس هستیم. من الان دارم بهت میگم این آقا با خودم آدم خوب هستیم، هم بهت نشون میدم وقتی میرم مثل شما کار کنیم توی WWE. مرسی.
Mohammed Hassan on his way to Raw for action in the upcoming weeks. And speaking of action, ladies and gentlemen, let's take...
This is my Uncle Akbar's business, which he worked long and hard to establish, just like many other Americans of Middle Eastern descent. He came to this country with just a few dollars in his pocket. And after a short amount of time, he achieved the American dream. And he bought his own store. But after 9/11, everything changed for Akbar and every other Arab American. You see, America used to be known as a melting pot, where all of us were guaranteed to have equal rights under the Constitution, where we were guaranteed equality. But for Arab Americans, there is no equality, which is why Akbar is being forced to close these doors, because people like you choose not to support him anymore. And just like Akbar, I'm beginning to understand the true America. I see all of your prejudices. I know the dirty, yellow underbelly of this country. What happened to Akbar won't happen to me. My name is Mohammed Hassan, and this is my manager, Khosrow Debari. And if need be, we will beat the prejudiced out of all of you. And no one, no WWE superstar, no one will get away with treating us like this anymore. And if necessary, I will lead a revolt against our very own country.
برای سپتامبر 11 همه چی عوض شد واسه ما. اسم من خسرو دیوریست، اینم محمد حسنه. اگر باید بکنیم شما رو کتک میزنیم تا فهمیدین غلطین. هیچ کسی توی WWE، هیچ کسی تو امریکا به ما بسترامی نمیتونه بکنه. اگر باید بکنیم یه جنگ شروع میکنیم با کشور خود ما امریکا.
As a professional wrestler, I know that joining the WWE requires a great deal of travel. And since 9/11, airport security has changed, and justifiably so. All of us must endure a certain amount of inconvenience. But what's not justifiable is the prejudice and outright harassment that people like myself and my manager have to endure. When none of you people have to put up with this, but because we're of Arab descent, we are singled out. We are humiliated. And often, we are strip searched because my name is Muhammad and his name is Kazuro. We are Arab Americans and we demand the same rights that any American has. And if you don't give us the respect that we demand, then I will beat it out of anyone who gets in my way.
همه چی عوض شد تو فرودگاه برای سپتامبر 11 ما میفهمیم. ولی یه چیزی من نمیفهمم، چرا فقط ما رو اذیت میکنی؟ چرا فقط تو چمدون ما نگاه میکنی؟ چون که اسم من خسروست، چون که اسم این آقا محمده. شما ما رو اذیت میکنید چون که فکر میکنید خارج هستیم، ولی غلطین. ما دوتا آمریکایی هستیم ولی داریم عصبانی میشیم با آمریکا. And هیچ کسی به ما بی‌احترامی نمیتونی بکنین.
Fozzie Bull Fuse. We have a power player here. We're live tonight and here in Charlotte. Apparently,
ببخشید. ببخشید. ببخشید پارتون به هم می‌زدم. شماها همتون باید به دوست من استرام نشون بدین. همتون وایسا بگو سلام به محمد حسن.
How does it feel? How does it feel to be having a nice, normal, fun time, and then, in an instant, your entire world changes. The fun stops, and all there's left to do is question why. Well, Arab Americans have felt like that for 3 years now, ever since 9/11. For tonight, enjoy your party. Because next week, live on Raw, I'll be making my debut. And then, you will begin to see the world as I see it. The party is over.
Great book.
All right. Now, just what would the holidays be without a cheap Mick Foley book plug?
Oh, boy.
Now, I said I had an important announcement to make, and believe it or not, this book is not it. Now, I'm not saying it's not important. I'm not saying it wouldn't make a really good Christmas gift idea. What I'm here to talk about is the fact that even though I've been known off and on as a Raw guy, for the last couple of years. Next week, I'm going to temporarily make a little jump over to SmackDown.
What? SmackDown?
Wait a second, guys. This isn't just any SmackDown. This is a very special edition of SmackDown, and I think you'll know what I mean after you take a look at this.
The last few days have been remarkable. I mean, I have never seen these troops as motivated. This was the best of my entire career. WWE put on a major performance for all the troops, and that's why on this tour, they reach many, many more than anyone has ever met before. This was really unique and the first of its kind. Commanders and senior NCOs said they've never seen bigger smiles on the troops. The troops said even though they're going to be away from Christmas, this is going to give them the comfort that they need. In my 43 years, this is the best tour I've ever seen.
May God bless all of you and have a safe and happy holiday season. And let's do this again in 2004.
Now, I might seem like an unlikely candidate to go overseas in support of our troops. After all, I'll never be called a big pro-war guy, and I've still got a couple of cases of John Kerry for President bumper stickers in my garage. Wait. I forgot, this is a red state, right? Yeah. Nonetheless, it was with great gratitude, it was a great honor for me to be invited to the Pentagon to serve as a spokesman for the Department of Defense and their America Supports You campaign. Because I know that supporting the troops goes way beyond any kind of political affiliation. And so I look at it as it will be one of the great privileges of my life to travel overseas and entertain the brave men and women who put their lives on the line for us every single day. Because it is our brave men and women
Muhammad Hassan, he is scheduled to be here tonight. Well, I know, certainly not now. I would thank God.
همه کی توی این ساختمون، همه کی توی خونه تلویزیون نگاه میکنین، وایسا بگو سلام به محمد حسن.
I have had enough. I've had to listen to these lies, and now you're gonna listen to me, like it or not. I used to be just like you, Mick Foley, and just like all of these people. I used to blindly support these troops, and I used to blindly support this country. Right up until 9/11. After 9/11, I was forced to open my eyes to the truth. And the truth is, it's people like us that are the real victims of this war. And the truth is that none of you people are real patriots. Because if you were, you would not support a war that promotes the unfair treatment of Arab Americans. This is no longer the land of the free. And this is no longer the home of the brave. I am a prisoner in my own country.
Prisoner.
And I feel your patriotism at every airport, on every corner, and especially right now.
All right, okay, listen, I appreciate your passion. And I did listen, and I can see the sense in a couple of things you say, although by and large, I disagree strongly with almost every word. But isn't it wonderful that you live in a great country like the United States of America, where you are free to express your views no matter how stupid they sound? Now listen, you annoyed me a little bit, but what's got me really down is you've chosen at this time to come out and interrupt my interview time after an 8-month absence. I'm here talking to the people in Huntsville, Alabama.
I knew you'd get that cheap pop in.
Good, good, I'm glad I interrupted you because I am sick of hearing you express your admiration for these troops, these gutless cowards. These heartless infidels.
Oh, now you're pissing me off. Yeah. You understand one thing, you've got that right, because throughout our country's history, brave men and women have bled and fought and died to give you the right to shoot your mouth off. My cousin Russ took a bullet at the Battle of the Bulge so you could shoot your mouth off. Sergeant Michael Caine left a leg in Iraq so you could shoot your mouth off. Nathan Hale was hanged so you'd have the right to say that.
How dare you lecture me on morality? You support an evil and unjust war.
I support America. The home of the brave, the land of the free. With one exception, you see, in this great country, you're free to shoot your mouth off everywhere, but one isolated 20-foot by 20-foot ring. Some call it the squared circle. I'll call it Foley Island. And should you care to step inside Foley Island, I assure you, democracy no longer reigns. Your rights no longer apply, save to, no. Should you choose to wander into Foley Island, you have got the right to feel my fist in your mouth. And you have got the right to feel this boot in your ass. So if you're feeling gutsy, come on, welcome ashore. Foley Island awaits you. Bring it, welcome. I'll be your guide. I'll beat your ass.
No, I don't think I will, because I will not fight a man that I don't respect.
First, I hope that everyone had a great Christmas.
Oh, goodness, getting better.
And on behalf of the entire WWE family, we would like to thank you for making 2004 a great year. And on a personal note, I would like to thank you for voting me the 2004 Babe of the Year!
Yes!
Congratulations.
I voted
and
early and often.
For my New Year's resolution, I promise that I will bend over backwards and forwards,
I'll bend a little further,
making 2005 even better. That's right. Backwards.
Oh.
And
wait a minute. What is the meaning of this? Stacy Dealer was just about to bend it like Beckham and we get this. to come out here?
I don't think so.
I mean, I happen to know some of the resolutions, New Year's resolutions that Stacey Keibler was about to tell us about. You should hear them, JR.
Love to have heard them.
I mean, they are very, very interesting. One of them actually involved me, JR.
Okay,
I don't want to say too much now, but...
Well...
And actually, one of her New Year's resolutions involved you, JR. I'll go ahead and spill the beans. I'm gonna buy you a... Well, never mind.
Gentlemen, I wasn't even finished.
Shema Alon, Bolo Dumso Khanum, Dumso, Dumso, Bolo Adita, Alon, Shema, Bolo Dumso! همگی باستا هم بگو سلام به محمد حسن.
It's محمد حسن, all right.
You know, I guess that I don't find this as surprising as I find it disgusting that a country that is a den of lies and a cesspool of hypocrisy can put on this facade of holiday cheer and goodwill towards all men. But in reality, America does not wish goodwill towards all men, only those that they see fit to show it to. And right now, especially right now, that does not include my Arab brothers. These aren't just my personal beliefs, people. These are undisputable, cold hard facts. A recent poll done at Cornell University, a prestigious American Ivy League institute, shows that at least half of all Americans believe that Arab Americans should have their civil liberties limited. The same civil liberties that are guaranteed to every human being under our Constitution. Limited. And not because we've done anything wrong. And not because we've committed any crimes. Simply because we are of Arab descent. Don't listen to me, people. You can find out for yourself right now at home. Go to news.cornell.edu and you can see the truth for yourselves. And the truth is that deep down inside your hearts, every single one of you is prejudiced. And the truth is that deep down, none of you have the guts to admit it to yourselves. And if you people don't open your eyes, and see what you're doing to my Arab brothers, to me, then my New Year's resolution will be to personally beat some sense into America.
Hey, Muhammad! It's infidels like these two who are what's wrong with America. The good old boys that don't give anyone from a different culture a chance. And you sit here and you preach your prejudice propaganda from a media perch to an audience of millions.
I don't know about an audience of millions, but I know I for one have heard just about enough from you two. And if you don't back off,
I'm gonna propaganda your face with my fist. Do you understand that?
Hey. Come on.
So, Candace, tell me about your Christmas holiday.
It was great. I got to spend so much time with my family in L.A. Wasn't exactly a white Christmas, but it got pretty cold for a
while. Boss, I hate to interrupt. Hey, Candace, how you doing, sweetheart?
Hi.
But he's here. Who's here? The special guest referee is here in the house right now.
Well, how do you know that he's the special guest referee?
How could I not know? I just can't believe that you didn't tell me that he was the person you were talking about. I can tell you this much, though. That Elimination Chamber match just got a lot more interesting.
I'm glad you think so.
Mr. Bischoff, I am sick of you. By those impersonators that you call announcers. Do you realize the power they have? They are the voices of Raw. And all they do is spew anti-Arab American propaganda to your television audience each week.
We are sick of the hate. And what do you suggest I do about that?
We want them in a match. We want King and JR in the ring. We want them in a position we can make them pay for their backwards thinking.
That's right. Look, Jerry the King Lawler may be a legend in the ring, but Jim Ross is not even a wrestler, so there's no way I'm gonna sanction a match like that. But I can be a fair man. Let's settle this like gentlemen. Next week, right in the middle of the ring, we'll have a debate.
A debate?
A debate. Muhammad Daivari versus Jerry the King Lawler and Jim Ross in a debate in the center of the ring. Now, gentlemen, if you'll excuse me, I have a very special guest that I must go see.
A debate?
Hey, آقا زبان. شاید این ما خوب باشه. من یه فکر دارم واسه من و شما. اون دوتا رو هفته دیگه میبینیم. امشب نمیخوایم کشتی کنیم. صبر کن.
America. As I was trying to say, please. America, at its core, is a racist nation. After all, this country was founded on slavery. And Arab Americans have not only been discriminated against since 9/11, but before 9/11 as well. This goes way, way back. I remember a time in this country where people would at least pretend to be polite, even though, just like now, you could still see the underlying contempt in their eyes. But then 9/11 happened, and everything came out. You people used a national tragedy as an excuse to let your real feelings towards Arab Americans come through. And now, you people feel like you have the right to openly express your discrimination without consequence and without reason. Searched, harassed, threatened, or even... been worse. And for what reason? Because we look differently than you? It is the arrogance and the intolerance of this country that is why we are the most hated nation in the world. And it is that intolerance and that arrogance is why you deserve it.
Jerry and JR, your rebuttal. Look. Hey. Are there racists in this country? Are there? Absolutely. But I got news for you, Hassan. There are racists and idiots in every country in the world. Now, if you think you've been treated unfairly, I don't have any problem with you coming out here and expressing that. But a few weeks ago, you came out here on national television and you called our troops that are putting their lives on the line every day for us gutless cowards. And that, Hassan, is unacceptable. Now, I don't think these people hate you because you're Arab Americans, because thankfully most Arab Americans aren't like you two. I'd be willing to bet that these people hate you two because you're a couple of loudmouth, obnoxious jackasses.
Hold on, Lawler. You know what? You're right. No, he's right. You're right. Most Arab Americans, they're not like us. In fact, most Arab Americans make me sick. Embrace a racist nation. Oh, you disagree, JR. You disagree. You know, for once, you've been quiet all night. And you're exactly the kind of person that I'm talking about. You're a member of the media. You lead all these puppets. You tell them what to think. But deep down inside, it sickens you that I'm just as American as you are. That I'm just as American as apple pie. As Mickey Mantle. As your Oklahoma Sooners. Yeah, that pisses you off, doesn't it? That gets you hot, doesn't it, JR? But you know what? You're not gonna do anything about it. Because you're just like America. When my back is turned, you're all tough talk. But when we're face to face, you back down like the coward that you are. Isn't that right? Tell me, JR, say it, say it, say it. Say it, JR. I dare you, right now, face to face.
I got something to say to you there, Mohammed. America's not a perfect place, but what country is? But when you unfairly characterize everybody as being a racist, and more importantly, when you badmouth our fighting men and women, I got a little advice for both you boys. As far as America is concerned, you love it or by God, you leave it.